हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पॉलिटेक्निक यड्रा इचलकरंजी, आई वेलकम ऑल टीवाई सिविल स्टूडेंट्स इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग. द सब्जेक्ट पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग कम्स विद द सब्जेक्ट कोड 22504. नाउ वी डिस्कस द वॉट इज अ पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग. द पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग works for minimizing the impact of engineering and technology on the natural resources. Rapidly increasing urbanization is stretching resources and infrastructure and threatening environmental quality. To maintain better public health, one must have safe quality of drinking water, effective methods for disposal of domestic and industrial waste, and pollution-free environment. This subject gives the detailed knowledge about various sources of water supply and quality parameters of public water purification. Now we can see the syllabus of public health engineering. The subject public health engineering comes for total 150 marks. Out of this 150 marks, 70 marks is for end semester examination, that is your final theory paper, and 30 marks is for PA under theory. In this 30 marks, 10 marks is for your micro project and 20 marks is the average of class test 1 and class test 2. There is a external examination for 25 marks, and 25 marks is for practicals. That is total mark of this subject is 150. Now we can see the syllabus of public health engineering. The subject PHE include total 5 units. In that, unit number 1 is resources, quantity and quality of water. This unit comes for 12 marks and include the subtopics sources of water, then quantity of water and quality of water. Basically, unit number 1 deals with the sources, quantity and quality of water. Then unit number 2 is purification of water. This unit is for 18 marks and include the subtopics purification of water, that is a treatment which can be used in purification of water, then miscellaneous water treatment and advanced water treatments. Then unit number 3 is conveyance and distribution of water. This unit is for 10 marks and include the syllabus conveyance and distribution of water. Then unit number 4 is domestic sewage and system of sewerage. This unit is for 18 marks and include the syllabus building sanitation, then system of sewerage and sewer appurtenances. Then the last unit is characteristics and treatment of sewage. This unit is for 12 marks and include the syllabus analysis of sewage and treatment of sewage, that is a analysis and treatment which can be used for sewage is included in this chapter. Hope you get the overview of the syllabus of public health engineering. Now we can start the syllabus. First unit is sources, quantity and quality of water. Unit number 1st of public health engineering comes with the title sources, quantity and quality of water. The first point of this unit is sources of water. What is a sources? Sources is a place from which water originates or can be obtained. Sources from where town get water supply, it may be ground or underground sources. There is a two sources of water, that is a underground and ground sources. The main sources of water is rain. Rain is the main source of water. Then there is a two main sources of water, surface and subsurface. Surface means ground water sources and subsurface means underground water sources. Then C See, first is surface sources. The surface sources is also known as the ground sources. Following are the various types of surface sources. First is streams. Streams is the first type of surface sources. In mountainous region, during rainy season, water from the top of mountains get collected and flow in the form of streams. That is the water which can be on the top of mountains is flow in the form of streams. Then second is rivers. Second source of surface water is rivers. Number of small streams flowing over from the mountains combined together and forms rivers. That is the streams are combined and from the river. Then lakes. In mountain, at some places, natural basins are formed with impervious beds. Water from streams generally move toward the to form lakes. That is the in mountain regions, some natural basins are formed and water is get stored in these basins and form the lakes. Then fourth source of groundwater is ponds. Ponds are depression in plains in which water is collected during the rainy season. It is a depressions in which water is collected during rainy season. Then fifth source of surface water is natural and artificial reservoirs. What is a reservoir? Reservoir is an open air storage area usually formed by masonry or earthwork to collect the water. In India, reservoirs are major source of water in summer. That is, water is stored in reservoirs and it is used in summer. It has a large capacity of water stored. Then, second point is subsurface sources of water. Subsurface sources is also known as the underground sources. A portion of rainfall infiltrate in the ground and get stored as a subsurface water at hard murum. That is, when rain is fall, some portion of water is infiltrate into the ground and stored as a subsurface water. That is a underground water. Then following are the subsurface water sources. First is spring. First source of subsurface water is spring. Sometimes where the groundwater is very high, the water comes out on the surface in the form of springs. That is, when groundwater level is high, then water is come on the ground in the form of springs. Then there is a two type of springs. First is a gravity spring and second is a artesian springs. In gravity springs, the underground water level rises or water flows through natural valley or depressions. That is, in gravity springs, so the water is flow under the gravity. Then second is the artesian springs. When the surface of earth drops sharply below the normal ground water table, then these springs are founded. Then second source of subsurface water is infiltration galleries. Generally, groundwater flows toward ponds or lakes. This water can be intercepted by digging canal or tunnel with piles at right angle. This groundwater tunnel are called as the infiltration galleries. That is, the infiltration galleries are constructed to store the underground water. Then, third type of subsurface water source is wells. Wells are vertical holes dug or drilled under the ground to trap the subsoil water is called as a wells. Then the wells are classified as dug wells, then driven wells and tube wells. There is a three types of wells. First is dug well, then driven well and tube well. The dug wells are excavated by the hand shovel to below the water table. Then driven wells are constructed by the driving a small diameter pipe into shallow water bearing sand or gravel. Then tube wells are the consist of an iron pipe with a solid steel point and lateral perforations near the end. That is the three types of wells. Hope you all get the concept about the first point of unit number 1, that is a surface sources and subsurface sources. Now we can revise again. What is a surface sources? Surface sources means on the ground water sources. These are the streams, rivers, lakes, then ponds, then natural and artificial reservoirs. Then second is subsurface sources, which include springs. Then there is a two types of springs, that is a gravity spring and artesian springs. Then second is a infiltration galleries. Second subsurface source, which this is a infiltration galleries. Then third is a wells. Then there is a three types of wells. First is a dug well, then second is driven well, and third is tube well. Hope you all get the idea about the surface and subsurface sources of water. Now the next point of unit number 1 is intake structures. What is a intake? Intake means go inside. In intake structures, water goes inside of intake from the resources like river, lake, and then water from intake structures goes to the water treatment plant. Then see, what is the intake structures? Intake structure are used for collecting water from the surface sources such as a river, lake, and reservoir and conveying it further to the water treatment plant. These are the masonry or concrete structures. The intake structures are constructed under the masonry or concrete. Then next point is types of intake structure. There are main four types of intake structures, that is a canal intake, then reservoir intake, then lake intake, and river intake. The canal intake is constructed on the canal. Then reservoir intake structure is constructed on the reservoir. Then lake intake structures are constructed on the bank of lake. And last one is a river intake, which is constructed on the river. Now see, first type of intake structure is canal intake. This is a diagram of canal intake structure. In this structure is constructed on the bank of canal, and the water from canal is flowed to this intake structure. This is a full supply level of water and this is a low water level. Now water from canal goes under this canal intake structure in this way. In this way, the screen is constructed or placed. The function of screen is remove the dirt from water. Then see the construction of canal intake. On the canal intake, the valve is provided to manage the water level of outlet. Then at the mouth of outlet, the mouth of outlet is in the shape of bale. Then on this mouth, hemispheric screen is provided to remove the dirt or fine particles from the water. Then there is only one outlet is provided for canal intake. The one outlet is provided because level of water is not changes in the canal. Canal has a constant water level. There is no change in water level. Hence one outlet pipe is provided. Now see the explanation of canal intake. The water level in canal is constant. Hence there is no need for provide pipe at various levels. There is only one outlet. There is no need of provide pipes at various levels. Then second point is a canal intake consists of a pipe placed in a brick masonry chamber constructed partly in the canal bank. That is a canal intake is constructed partly in the canal bank. Then third point is on one side of chamber opening is provided that is a coarse screen for the entrance of water. As we see in the figure, there is a coarse screen for entrance of water. Then at other side of canal has outlet pipe which carries the water. At other side of canal has outlet pipe which carries the water to the water treatment plant. If in exam you had the question what is a canal intake, then you have to draw this diagram, then write this explanation. Now the second type of intake is reservoir intake. Reservoir intake is constructed at the reservoir. Now see the construction of reservoir intake. The reservoir intake has the three intake pipes because the water level in reservoir is changes gradually. For these intake pipes are provided. It is a low water level. Then at valve room, valves are provided to control the flow of water in the intake pipes. Then it is a concrete wall which can be constructed for reservoir intake. Then foot bridge or tool bridge, it can be used for go to the valve room to control the valve. Then intake well. Intake well is constructed to the intake water. Then outlet pipe. From this outlet pipe, the water from the canal is, sorry, water from the river reservoir intake is go to the water treatment plant. Now see the explanation of reservoir intake. A reservoir is forming by constructing a dam or weir across the river. Reservoir is formed by constructing a dam or weir across the river. The water from river is stored by constructing the dam in the reservoir. Then the water level in the reservoir changes from time to time. Intake pipes are provided at different level. The water level in reservoirs are changed from time to time. That is from some period the water level is changes. Hence the intake pipes are provided at different levels. Then reservoir intake is mostly used for draw water from earthen dam. For draw the water from earthen dam, the reservoir intake is used. Then third type of intake is lake intake. Now see the construction of lake intake. This is a lake level, that is a water level in the lake. The lake intake is constructed under the lake. It is a river bed or the bed of the lake. Then the intake is constructed on the bed of the lake. It is a cover. Cover is used to avoid the entry of dirt in the intake. Then it is a rock. The side of intake is rock, or the side of intake has the rock. Then it is a inlet pipe. The water from lake goes under the inlet pipe. Then it is a go to the bank, and from the bank it is a go to the treatment plant. That is one point is in lake intake we have the inlet pipe, while in the reservoir intake and canal intake we have outlet pipe. The lake intake is under the water, hence it is a inlet pipe. Now we can see the explanation of lake intake. For obtaining water from lake, mostly submerged intake are used. Submerged means under water. For obtaining water from lake, mostly underwater intakes are used. These intakes are constructed in the bed of lake, which consists of pipe and a bell-shaped opening, which is protected. This construction is under the bed of lake and which consists of pipe and a bell-shaped opening. This pipe has a bell-shaped opening. Now, next type of intake is river intake. Now, see the diagram of river intake. The river intake is constructed on the bank of river. This is a HFL. HFL means high flood level. Then it is a LWL. LWL means low water level. Water from river goes under the river intake by the screens or penstock with screens. From this, the water from river goes under the river intake. Then pumps are used to raise the water to the rising main. And from rising main, the water is go to the work or to the water treatment plant. Then sump well is used to collect the sump or collect the dirt. Then screens are used to remove the dirt from the water. Now see the explanation of river intake. It has a circular masonry tower with 4 to 7 meter diameter. This is a masonry tower. It is a have the diameter of 4 to 7 meter. Then it has a constructed along the river bank at the place from where water can be drawn in the required quantity. The river intake is constructed on the river bank at the location where the water has in large quantity or water has a larger depth. The types of river intakes are wet intake, dry intake and movable intake. Just remember these types. We don't need the explanation of these types. First is a wet intake, then dry intake and movable intake. Hope you all get the intake structures. Now we can revise the again all intake structures. First is canal intake structure, then river intake structure, then lake intake structure and reservoir intake structure. Hope you all get the intake structure. Now we can again revise all points in this lecture. First, what we had seen, we see the sources of water. There is a two main sources of water, that is a surface sources and subsurface sources. In that, first is a surface sources. It is also known as a ground sources. It has the types. First is streams, then second rivers, then third is lakes, fourth is ponds, and fifth is natural and artificial reservoirs. These five are the types of surface sources. Then next is the subsurface sources of water. In this, what is the subsurface sources? It is also known as the underground sources. And the types of subsurface sources are, first is the springs, then types of springs are gravity springs and artesian springs. Then second type of subsurface source is infiltration galleries. Then third is wells. Then what is the types of wells? Dug wells, driven wells and tube wells. Now see third point of this chapter, that is the intake structures. Intake structures means the structures which is used for collecting water from the surface sources such as a river, lake and reservoir and convey this water to the water treatment plant. These intake structures are constructed in masonry or in concrete. Now see the types of intake structure. There are four types of intake structure. First is canal intake, then second is reservoir intake, then lake intake and river intake. Now see, this is a diagram of canal intake. Then it is a explanation of canal intake. The water level in canal is constant, and there is a no need of provide the pipe at various levels. Then next is reservoir intake. This is a construction or diagram of reservoir intake. Reservoir intake is constructed on the bank of river. Then third is a lake intake, and this is a diagram of lake intake. Lake intake is construct in the water, that is a in submerged water. Then fourth is a river intake. River intake is constructed on the bank of river. Hope you all get these 3 points of unit number 1. Thank you.